Hello everybody and welcome back. I'm Nicola Thompson, Somerset Music. Thank you for joining me again this week and I hope you enjoyed last week's songs. Last week we were basking, well when I made the videos anyway, we were basking in glorious, gorgeously hot sunshine. And today, as I look out my window, it's still raining. It's raining and it's grey and it's cold, so I hope I didn't jinx it. Here we are again, week number two. And we started some new warm-ups last week. So I thought we would start, we would use those to begin with this week because they were new and because I did send you away to do your homework and try and practice them, which were our new tongue twisters. First of all though, let's start by just trying to warm up our voices. So I'd like you to roll your shoulders back. I'm gonna do eight of each. Can you do it with me? Are you ready? 1, 2, 3. 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Brilliant, that should stretch out that chest. Okay, now we're gonna look left, center, right, center, 8 times. You ready? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Brilliant. And then just give, put your hands on your hips, which I know you can't quite see, but hands on hips, and just circle your hips to the count of 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Go the other way. 1, 2, a bit faster. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. And have a good shake. Okay, can you have a go now at just chewing? Imagine you've got a really sticky toffee in your mouth. You're going to chew it, but at the same time as chewing it, you're going to hum. Okay, so just join me and chew that toffee. And when you're chewing that toffee, go all around your notes. So up, down, anywhere you want to put it, just up and down. Just kind of listen to what I do and have a go yourselves. Super. It's all about waking up the face and getting that jaw working. Okay, let's now have a go at just blowing some horse blows. Go top to bottom with me. So again, go and again. Brilliant. Let's go from lower in our pitch to up higher in our pitch with me. Fantastic. And now imagine that you have got a yo-yo and you're yo-yoing up and down and you're going to go yo-yo, yo-yo, lovely playing with that sound. Okay, good, good work. Okay, let's start then with our tongue twister. Can you, I hope you've been practicing it. So our first one was, here's a really tricky tongue twister to try. Say it with me, let's do it 4 times. Okay, I'll do it at a slower tempo to start with. Again, are you ready? Here's a really tricky tongue twister to try. And again, here's a really tricky tongue twister to try. Make that mouth move. Here's a really tricky tongue twister. A really tricky tongue twister. A really tricky tongue twister to try. Good. Really make sure you're moving that mouth. Okay. So, again, it's about getting the mouth awake, the face awake, and the tongue working. Okay. So that it really is working hard in enunciating words in our songs. Remember, it's to the tune of She'll Be Coming Round the Mountain. So with me. Here's a really, 1, 2, 3. Here's a really tricky tongue twister to try. Here's a really tricky tongue twister to try. Here's a really tricky tongue twister, a really tricky tongue twister, a really tricky tongue twister to try. Brilliant. Have a little rest. I'm going to do that one more time. Are you ready? One, two, three. Here's a really tricky tongue twister to try. Here's a really tricky tongue twister to try. Here's a really tricky tongue twister, a really tricky tongue twister, a really tricky tongue twister to try. Fantastic. And if you've been practicing, you should notice a much improved sound that you are producing this week and hearing the words that you are singing. Okay, the next line was, sing a song of silly squirrel sewing socks. I have to think really hard on that one. The S sound. Sing a song of silly squirrel sewing socks. Let's say it four times first of all. One, two, three. Sing a song of silly squirrel sewing socks. Sing a song of silly squirrel sewing socks. Sing a song of silly squirrel sewing socks. One more. Sing a song of silly squirrel sewing socks. Okay, let's try that from the top. Sing a song. One, two, three. Sing a song of silly squirrel sewing socks. Sing a song of silly squirrel sewing socks. Sing a song of silly squirrels. A song of silly squirrels. A song of silly squirrels sewing socks. Brilliant. Okay. Little boy there. Make sure you're still having that lovely posture. Feet slightly hip width apart to sing it. Okay. Let's try it one more time. After three. One, two, three. Sing a song of silly squirrel sewing socks. Sing a song of silly squirrels sewing socks. Sing a song of silly squirrels. A song of silly squirrels. A song of silly squirrels sewing socks. Fantastic start. Well done. We're going to have a go at our grand old Duke of York, which is a simple, nice, easy nursery rhyme, but actually quite musically challenging because you are using your thinking voice. You are changing the actions and the words around, and you're having to be physically active with it as well. So actually, it's a brilliant one for using in our musical warm-ups. So first of all, remember, we're just going to keep it the straight way that it's sung. When he was up, he was up, and when he was down, he was down. When he was only halfway up, he was neither up nor down. Okay, so can you join with me? And maybe you've been practicing this one as well this week, hopefully. You ready? Oh, one, two, three. Oh, the grand old Duke of York, he had 10,000 men. He marched them up to the top of the hill and he marched them down again. And when they were up, they were up. And when they were down, they were down. And when they were only halfway up, they were neither up nor down. Brilliant. Okay, so hopefully you've got that one secured. So I'm just going to move this just so you can see. Okay, so now with the grand old Duke of York, instead of singing the up first, we sing the down. And when we're supposed to be singing down, we're singing up. So we're reversing the words. Are you ready? It goes. Oh, the grand old Duke of York, he had 10,000 men. He marched them down to the bottom of the hill and he marched them up again. And when they were down, they were down. And when they were up, they were up. And when they were only halfway up, they were neither down nor up. Brilliant. And if you're anything like me, your heart is starting to race a bit now. So it must be getting warm. Now we're going to use our thinking voice. So we're not going to sing the ups or the downs. We are just going to do the actions. Are you ready? One, two, three. Oh, the grand old Duke of York, he had 10,000 men. He marched them to the top of the hill and he marched them again. And when they were, and when they were down, and when they were only halfway, they were neither. No. See, when I get it wrong sometimes, we try it one more time. We're going to get those arms and those legs marching. You ready? One more time. One, two, three. Oh, the grand old Duke of York, he had 10,000 men. He marched them to the top of the hill and he marched them again. And when they were, they were. And when they were, they were. And when they were only halfway, they were neither nor. Well done. Good work. Okay, welcome, and you join me at the piano now, where we're going to have a go at our next song that we're going to learn in our week two. Now, last week, I hope you enjoyed practicing and working on Don't Worry, Be Happy, which was a song from the late 80s, and it started me thinking as to where we could take our singing this term. So I've decided to take us on a song journey through the decades. So we're going to go back in time now. We were in the late 80s last week. We're going to go back to kind of the 70s. This band does creep into the early 80s, but I've chosen a band that have been incredibly influential, particularly in the songwriting field, and very much a big influence on popular music. And they have written one of the most successful musicals that runs in London at the moment. So it is a song by Benny and Bjorn from ABBA. So it's an ABBA number. It's also a lovely song. I think it's quite appropriate at the moment. It's called I Have a Dream. And I think this one was very much kind of creeping into the early 80s, this song. I remember my grandma buying me this on 7-inch record, in fact. And that's how I first got into ABBA. And I know one of my dreams was to sing, just like the blonde lady that's in ABBA, because she has a beautiful voice. So hopefully you'll have got the video sent over along with the link, with my links that I've sent out for the week, and you will have watched it and maybe have a go and have a look at some of the other stuff that ABBA have sung. Certainly towards the latter end of their careers, they became brilliant storytellers in their songwriting. So we are going to learn I Have a Dream. I've also sent this week a word file over. So if you're doing this classroom, you'll hopefully have your song sheets with you. And if at home, hopefully you've got some way of accessing the words to learn the song as well. So we shall begin. So hopefully you'll have listened to it and you will be familiar with the song now. So I'm going to go straight into teaching it and so we can learn it. This is a great song for singing assemblies as well, so you could use this one when we can get back to being collectively together in the hall as a singing assembly song. And it goes like this: if I sing, you sing back to me. Are you ready? I have a dream, a song to sing. Your turn. To help me cope with anything. Your turn. To help. Sorry, I'll start again for you. 1, 2, 3, 4, 1. To help me cope with anything. Okay, so those two phrases together go like this. I'll sing them, you sing them back. Contrasting style to our song last week. Last week was quite up tempo and very happy and boppy. This one is what we call more of a ballad style, so a slower in tempo number. So next part goes. If you see the wonder of a fairy tale. Your turn. If you see the wonder. Even if you fail. Okay, so let's put all that together. Just sing it straight away with me. If you see the wonder. If you see the wonder of a fairy tale, you can see the future. Even if you fail. Lovely, well done.
Just make sure if you're sitting down like I am at the piano, sit up nice and tall just to give you all that space for your singing to happen. So should we go from the top? I have a dream, a song to sing to help me cope with anything. If you see the wonder of a fairy tale, you can take the future even if you fail. I have, and I have a dream, a song to sing, to help me cope with anything. If you see the wonder, so the next bit goes, this is where you need to make sure you are sitting nice and tall, you're really controlling those tummy muscles, and you're singing with your cheekbones nice and high, because we're going to go into our head voice a little bit here. I believe in it. Oh, sorry, I'll do that again. I believe in angels, something good in everything I see. So that's I believe in angels, something good in everything I see. Have a go. Ready, and I believe in angels, something good in everything, something good in everything I see. And then it's the same, repeat the phrase, I believe in angels. I believe in angels, when I know the time is right for me. So the second part of that sentence is, when I know the time is right for me. Let's go from the I believe in angels. One, two.
I believe in angels.
When I know the time is right for me. So those two phrases. I believe in angels, something good in everything I see. I believe in angels when I know the time is right for me. Okay, so let's do those two bits. Is I'll cross the stream, I have a dream. And that goes.
I cross the stream, I have a dream.
And you will notice in this, there are some lovely long places to sing really lovely long phrases. So that's what you want to work on, making a really nice long phrase sound. As in,
I have a dream.
And then you've got,
I'll cross the stream.
So four beats you want to keep those notes going from. Four. So go from I'll cross the stream. Ready? One, two, three.
I'll cross the stream. I have a dream.
Lovely, well done. Okay, let's do everything from I believe in angels to the end, and then we'll put the whole of that first verse and that bit of chorus together. Okay, I believe in angels. And that's our note. So remember to sit up nice and tall. Ready?
I believe in angels, something good in everything I see.
Together from the top. So I have a dream, a song to sing. I'll try and play you the introduction as well. It goes.
Mm-hmm.
So now we come to the second verse. So same words for the opening of the second verse. I have a dream. And then it goes, a fantasy to help me through reality. Okay, so if I sing, you sing back, and I will do a line, line.
I have a dream, a fantasy.
Sure, remember that you're singing through those phrases at the end of the sentences that hold beautifully, make lovely long singing phrases. Okay, second part, to help me through reality.
To help me through reality.
Dream, a fantasy to help me through reality.
And I have a dream, a fantasy to help me through reality.
Fantastic. Okay. And my destination makes it worth the while, pushing through the darkness still another mile. Okay, so if I do that, break that into two sentences again.
And my destination makes it worth the while.
Your turn.
And my destination
makes it worth. From and my destination. Ready?
And my destination makes it worth the while.
Pushing through.
Pushing through the darkness. Still another mile.
And then, lucky for you, the words are exactly the same as we did in the second part of the first verse. I believe in angels, something good in everything I see. I believe in angels. When I know the time is right for me, I'll cross the stream. I have a dream. Should we try all of that bit at the second part of the verse? I believe in angels.
Singing
was better than mine because I lost my breath then. So remember, keeping those lovely long notes at the ends of phrases. Right, let's put verse two together. And I will play the introduction again.
A fantasy.
Right, let's put the whole song together now. I practiced the introduction, so I promise I'm going to get it right this time. Let's sing it all the way through from the top, and then I'm going to tell you what my challenge is for this week. And I hope everyone in the room could hear you really holding those beautiful phrases and really try working, if you are doing this in the classroom, to sing it with a lovely unison sound and holding those phrases together and coming off together, because it makes such a difference in the power of the music that you are singing. And if you're doing it at home, maybe you could involve the rest of your family to have a sing with you. Now, here is my challenge for this week. I've got a couple. Challenge number one is I'm going to send over just a piano backing track with this. So once you've learned the song and you've learned it with me, you can have a go at singing it in the classroom together or at home. And then I would like you to, if you can, send either a sound file of you singing it, or if you can, a video file of you singing it. And I would somehow like to collate it all together, because I think that title of I Have a Dream is quite poignant at the moment. And maybe even you could try and be really clever with it. And if there are some budding songwriters amongst you, using that backing track, maybe you could have a go at writing your own verses about what your dreams are. So what is your dream? Have a go at just writing it and seeing if you can record it. And maybe if one of you writes the words and comes up with something, you could teach the whole of your class to sing it, or the people that are in your group at the moment to sing it. And again, at home, maybe get some people to help you out with singing it at home. It's just about enjoying it and just enjoying the message that it's giving. Challenge number two is, if you fancy a little bit of work on top of the work you're being set, have a go at finding out a bit about ABBA and the history of ABBA and who they are, where they're from, where they got their big break from, because I haven't told you any of that yet, and they've got a wonderful story of how it all began. So I look forward to seeing or hearing and seeing any bits of work that you produce out of this week's learning. Thank you very much for joining me again. I look forward to seeing you next week, and I hope that I will see some work from you all. So thank you very much. Have a good week, and I will see you next time. Goodbye.